Hello, this is Michael McCarthy, and in this video we're going to take a look at doing some dynamics with Ornatrix. You can see here I have a pretty basic scene with a sphere emitting some hair. I have my sphere object, and I have guides from surface, edit guides in case we want to do some styling, and hair from guides. Now we're going to apply an OX dynamics modifier to get started, and we want to do that on the guides as opposed to the hair. So always make sure that you kind of select the guides or below where you've generated hair from. So we're going to go and select OX Dynamics. And the OX Dynamics modifier is using the Mass Effects simulation system in order to simulate. And this is great because it's a fast and simple method of simulating, and it participates with all the Mass Effects objects in the 3ds Max scene. So we can just bring up the Mass Effects toolbar and press play. And when we do that, you'll see your hair, kind of shake into place and being dynamic with any objects that are there, or just with itself at this point. The other thing that I like about using the Mass Effects dynamic system is the ability to test out and learn your dynamics parameters in real time. Dynamics is highly dependent on your scene scale and size of the hairs and other things like that. So it's important that you can kind of interactively play with those parameters. If I press play here and I scroll down into my internal forces rollout, you can see I have a couple of parameters that are pretty important. First is going to be the spring and flexibility, and that's the springiness that the hair has to try and achieve its end goal. Below that I have the swing limit or bendiness, and that's how much the hair is kind of able to bend and be limp. So if I take this and increase it to something like 100, you're going to see it's really going to be able to kind of bend into place. And if I decrease the spring here, it's going to even drop a lot more. So balancing the spring and the global limit can help you to either get really wispy and flowing hair, or the opposite, which would be hair that kind of follows the original state or the hairstyle or groom that you've made. So if I bring this back up to 1000, you can see the hair try and puff up a little bit, and I'll bring this back down to maybe 50, and you can see it kind of pop into place into that just original groom that we had. Now, we didn't really have anything besides the hair just sitting there going straight out. So let's go back into our Edit Guides modifier and click on Brush, and we'll just grab the brush and do a quick something to this hair. All right, so we have some sort of hairstyle that we're working with. It's important that when you work with dynamics that you can keep this sort of hairstyle while still having a little flowiness to your hair. So that's what these parameters are going to do for us. If I click on play, you can see that we're still kind of holding our hairstyle, but it's definitely falling out a little bit. So this may be good for whatever animation you happen to be making, or you may want the hair to be really tight, or what I think of as hairsprayed. So if you want that, you can really set that global limit down and increase your global spring a bit in order to achieve very close to the same result that you would have from your groom or your styling that you've done below this. If I just kind of reset this, you can see that's really pretty close to what we have. It kind of falls into place and then bounces back. And you can get, certainly even stiffer by bringing the global limit down a little bit more. And you can do this interactively. So if I'm pressing play, I can bring that there, or I can set it to 100, and I can see how it's going to affect my hair at any given time. So I'll just pause this right here. Now, another thing that's really powerful about the Ornatrix system is obviously using a modifier-based situation. And when we apply our dynamics in this way, right above the guides, we're able to do things before the dynamics, as we saw with brushing the hair, and after. So we could style our hair or add different things after that. So if I just kind of turn this off, then what I might want to do is add a little bit more strand detail after dynamics. So if I go in and choose OX strand detail, I can crank this up to maybe 40, which is going to give me more kind of knots along the spline in order to pass up to something like a curl. So I'll just choose OX strand curling. And now I can kind of play with that curl and adjust things like the magnitude, the phase, or however it is that I want it to kind of curl out. And all that is going to happen above the dynamics, because something like a curl like this would be pretty difficult to simulate. You still want the curl to kind of be there. And overall, the dynamics is probably going to be larger than that the width of the curl anyways. So that's the type of thing that you want to simulate. So I can go back down here and I can still simulate. I'll just reset. And you can see these curls, you know, will fall into place, but they're actually happening after the dynamics. So we're able to really keep those there very simply without having to have a huge amount of detail in our dynamic simulation. And we can kind of play around with that bendiness again. I'll set this maybe to 90, and you can see how that kind of plays out there. Now, another thing that's really great about the Mass Effect system is, in addition to the speed and the flexibility, is our ability to interact with other things in the 3ds Max scene. So if I grab this sphere right here, and I'll just zoom out a little bit, we can see that we have a sphere in the scene that we could bring in, and it could be a rigid body as well. So if I take this and just say set as rigid body, and press play, then what's going to happen is we're going to see our hair simulate, and we're going to see our rigid body come down and hit our hair. And if I select my hair, I can go into dynamics again, and I can do things like increase this, and you'll see that it'll push that ball out and kind of push it off to the side. So that, depending on its mass and its weight, will have a different effect. So, you know, if I go back here and maybe I'll set this to 30, I could go into this and I could change its mass overall. So, I don't know, we'll change this to 500 to be a little bit bigger and squash the hair a little bit more. And it'll come in and it'll really have more of an effect on the hair. This hair tends to be a little bit stiff at the moment. So I'll play with that and bring it down. And we'll press play again. So other objects in the scene we can also kind of play with, like animated objects. I'll just hide this object. So here's our sphere drop and here's our animated sphere. So if I move this in and I select this sphere, you can see that that's going by and it's kind of brushing by our surface. So we'll take this and we'll make this a kinematic rigid body, and we'll go ahead and simulate that. And you can see our hair goes into place, and then this object kind of brushes by and interacts with that hair. So rigid bodies in kind of any form, kinematic, so on, can interact with this hair, which is pretty interesting. Of course, the next thing we might want to look at is the Mass Effect cloth, which can interact with the hair as well. I'm not exactly sure how practical it is, but it's certainly an interesting thing to do. So we'll get rid of this, and I'll grab this M cloth piece. And actually, you know what? We'll bring our sphere drop back into place. And I'll grab this piece right here. I'll turn it into M cloth. And we'll go ahead and simulate. So now what'll happen is this cloth is going to hit the hair, and then our object is going to kind of interact with that. We have a little bit of interpenetration there, but you can kind of see how these objects kind of interact together. If we had more steps in our sampling time, then we'd get a better result out of that. So we can kind of play around with that too. Let me just hide these objects, and I want to show one more thing that's kind of interesting about the Mass Effect system. So we'll take this sphere and that, kind of hide that, and I'm just going to zoom in here. With Ornatrix and Mass Effects, we've given it the ability to have the object affect the hair and the hair affect the object, which is a little bit of a cyclical redundancy. In order to do that, what we're going to do is just kind of make a reference of our object so that we can have the hair actually interact with it. So if I take this object and I go to Edit, Clone, I can choose Reference. And I'm going to just call this Hair Surface Ref and click on OK. This reference is really what we want to be dealing with in the scene. So I'm going to take this, and because it's a reference, I'm going to be able to add the dynamic rigid body to it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the original hair surface. So I have my hair surface here and my hair surface there. And I'm actually going to parent the hair object to this hair surface instead of that original one. So I'll just grab this and drag it down there. And we can hide this original one now. So now what we have is we have this rigid body, which is referencing the original sphere that grows the hair off of it. And the hair is linked to that referenced object. So what we have is the ability to just kind of drop this sphere and have it land on the ground and be affected by the ground, and the hair is affecting the sphere as well. So if I kind of bring this back and do some adjustments to my dynamics, I'll go in and I'll give these a little more strength so it can kind of hold up better. I'll set that to 10. And you can kind of see this drag or drop onto the ground and kind of spring up. And one thing we can see is this is actually being affected by some of the other objects in the scene that are hidden. So I'm going to bring back these other objects here so that we can kind of see them. And you can see that all these objects are kind of affecting this. So it's getting hit by the kinematic object as well as the cloth. And this other object is hitting it as well. And the wall is not part of this quite yet, but we can take this and set that to a static rigid body. And everybody will kind of hit the wall, except for the kinematic object, of course. So that starts to push it, and the cloth will hit the wall, as well as our hair, and the other object will kind of go and bounce off the wall there. So kind of an interesting scenario with all these objects playing together. One other thing that I wanted to look at quickly is really having all of these alone. So I'm just going to go disable these quickly. So I'm going to grab that guy, and we'll grab our cloth and disable that. I'll leave the wall, and I'll hide these guys too. So sphere, and cloth. We're going to simulate this again, and we should be able to see it just kind of puff up and stand on its own a little bit right there. And I'm going to add in a force. So I'll go over to our forces, grab a P-bomb, and just kind of put that into place. From our dynamics modifier, we'll scroll down, choose add force. Then we should be able to see probably a little bit of effect of this force here. It's not really affecting it so much, so I'm going to go into the force. We can see the start time of this P-bomb is at frame 30. Its strength is 1, which is very low. I'll just set it to 100. And we should see this playback and right around frame 30. We should see it kind of blow and push the hairs over to the wall. So now I can maybe increase that a little bit. And you can see that kind of hit the wall. Then it's going to kind of bounce off and bounce back. So you can incorporate forces as well. And really most of this is the hair. If the hair wasn't really getting affected in here, then it wouldn't be pushing this ball quite that much. So the hair is kind of dragging that ball along with it, which is a pretty fun result to have. Now I'm just going to do one more thing to kind of get a better preview of what's going on here. So I'm going to add a OX mesh from guides, or mesh from strands, so that I can actually get a mesh here. And before that, I'll add an OX render modifier, so that we can get some hair in here. And in hair from guides, in the view count, I'm just going to increase that quite a bit. So we'll set it to something like that. And you can see that we get a really nice result right here in the viewport. You can really get some nice detail with and preview detail with what's going on there. So we'll grab that guy. And to finalize the simulation, we'll go into Mass Effects and go in and we'll just say Bake All. This will go through and we'll get our simulation. We get our bomb blowing up and pushing that over to the other side, bouncing off the wall. And once this is all done, it'll all be baked and kind of play back in real time, which is pretty great. So we're all done. You can see that we can scrub to any point in the timeline here. I'll just kind of zoom in and come down. You know, when this hits the ground, we can kind of see that. If we hold and just let nitrous kind of do its thing, you get a really nice result with the anti-aliasing and even shadows in the scene. Kind of comes in here, hits the wall, and we can see the result there. So some pretty cool interactive feedback, not only with Mass Effects, but the in-viewport display and preview of Ornatrix. So this is just about the end of this demo, but I did want to talk a little bit about, we've looked at a lot of the real pro and great features of using Mass Effects, the integration with the Mac scene, interactive editing of your dynamic simulation, which produces, you know, that's a really fast learning curve. Having all these objects kind of play with each other is pretty good. And the implementation of, you know, keeping your kind of groom and having it in your modifier stack, which is really great. There are definitely some drawbacks to Mass Effects, just because it's really kind of a game engine simulation type of thing. So, you know, if you throw too much at it, you know, for film or broadcast type of stuff, just like any other Mass Effect simulation, it's going to have its upper limit. So it's a great thing to quickly get you started and do dynamics on all sorts of different characters and objects and things. But we do like to present another option in order to do some more high-end simulations using cloth strips. The other thing to kind of be aware of when you're working with Mass Effects is when you do have it in the modifier stack here, although we've worked out pretty well today, pressing play and going back and forth, it always likes to be the top of the stack. So sometimes you can get Mass Effect script error if you press play and you have a lot of modifiers on top of it. It's really recommended that you turn these modifiers off in order to simulate in OX Dynamics with Mass Effect. This is something that's just kind of built into the Mass Effect system that is difficult to get around. But if you just turn off your modifiers on top of it, if you're running into any issues, then you should turn out okay. So those are some kind of caveats when playing with Mass Effects. So in the next video, we're going to look at how to use some cloth type dynamics with Ornatrix and the really massaged and production proven workflow to do that. Thank you very much.